Welcome children, welcome to our classroom. Okay, today we are in the classroom environment. Last video we had been in the garden. I thought the garden is the best place where I can enjoy as well as you also can, you also visit the school. So I thought you better go in the garden. Now today in the classroom, the environment, I am talking about environment, the part 2. Right, and we are going part 2, this is revision. First lesson I already taught you earlier in classroom. Those who are absent that time, you can go through this revision. By that revision you will understand, definitely you will understand. So what is in this topic we are going to study, that what is an ecosystem and human environment. In last topic we discussed about lithosphere, hydrosphere as well as atmosphere and biosphere. Coming topic is, what is ecosystem? This is a new word for you, ecosystem. So please understand it. Okay. So what is ecosystem? Before I start, let me understand one story, a small story. There was an NCC camp, and in that Ravi was in that camp, even JC was in the camp, and Hira was also in the camp. So JC and Ravi, they were talking. They were telling, Jesse was telling, what a heavy downpour. It reminds me the home in Kerala. You should come and see how there are so many poor winds. There are more rain in Kerala. And you can find over lavish. You can find the last green fields and coconut plantation in Kerala. Then Hira from Jaisalmer, she was telling there was no rain. No rain, and we only see the care peaks and sand, and I so as far as our eyes goes, that much you can find the care peaks only. But you also find the camels, said Ravi. Okay, so Hira says not only just camel, if you visit our desert, you will find snakes, lizard, many insects too. So Ravi wondered, why do animals, the vegetation, and the way the people live, where from place to place, are they related to each other? Oh yes, very much, so the teacher replied. So it means all are interdependent on each other. You can't find, there is nothing, coconut trees, you will not find in desert. You will find either more water. Or you will not find camel in Kerala. You will find more elephant in Kerala. So it is interdependent on each other because of climate, because of plants and animals. So this is nothing but ecosystem. So there is a good definition in front of you. You can see this definition. All plants and animals and human beings depend on their intermediate surrounding. We are also dependent on our surrounding. If we go in somewhat known, very Leh-Ladakh, it is very difficult to survive for us. It is very difficult for surviving us. So that means we are not dependent on that, and we are born to a Maharashtra climate and our weather, all is totally we are dependent on that. So that is making a difference. So all the plants and animals depend on everybody's surrounding. Often they were also dependent on each other, totally depend on animals and depend on plants, and plants and depend on animals. This relation between the living organism as well as relation between the organism and their surrounding forms and ecosystem. This is nothing but ecosystem. You can find solar radiation, you can find your habitation, you will find your what you call disconnections, you will also find many things in rain. All these are interdependent relation. Even you can find the soil organism, you can find many things. So this is nothing but ecosystem. There could be an ecosystem of a large rainforest, even grassland, even desert, even mountain, even lake, even ocean, even a small pond. Right? You can see this small pond. This is small pond at the Thermodex School. So even a small pond you can find. Do you think that the park in which Ravi and his friends playing formed an ecosystem? Is the question. This is question for you. Is that that? Do you think the park in which Ravi and his friends were playing form an ecosystem? Ecosystem, naturally plants and different environment. So naturally it will be a ecosystem. This is your textbook page number 4. This is from textbook. Then before we talk, I would like to share with you, on 5th July every year the World Environmental Day is celebrated. This year also we celebrated, though this pandemic, we celebrated World Environmental Day, because on that day the world, whole world want the environment should be clean and pure. So, and let me tell you that mostly in Maharashtra from 5th June to 15th June are they used to plant the trees. Thousands of trees were planted in this time. So this is, here is World Environmental Day, 5th June, don't forget it, we are learning this thing. I think so, if you were in school, we had already planned something, okay. So now, and one is barter system. Now what is barter system? I think so you know in history, you study. It is a trade in which the goods are exchanged without use of money. With this, that trade is going. That is also one type of human environment. Now we will come to the next point. That is human and man-made environment. Human and man-made environment. So what is man-made? Man environment related to the elements made by the human beings in the activity and survive. They are modified by the nature environment and suits to their needs by a man-made. It includes road, building, bridges, vehicles, farms, mines. Actually, God has given a beautiful environment. From that, we are utilizing it. So, it has become a human-made environment. That means, God has given us coal mines. When we are using the coal, that means we are using the human-made, we are making the environment. This is made by the human. Or if you are, God has given you rock and you are making the road, or you are making a buildings, whatever you are using for the rock, that means when you are using is a human-made environment. Right. Then human-made environment consists of human being themselves as an individual. Yes. We are also God gifted. We are also environment. So we made by ourselves, that is also environment. Now let me give an example. Humans learn many new ways and changes environment. So they learn growing crops. Land is given by God and we are growing crops. Domestic animals and settling life. The wheel they invented, it is surplus food. That is barter system. I am just not talking barter system. That also emerged. Trade and commerce development. Industrial revolution and transportation become so faster because of this. And information of revolution made communication easier and speed across the world. Have you ever thought this? Have you ever thought why you are eating a juicy watermelon in summer and even you are eating the hot roasted in winter? Or why you want? Because your body wants a perfect balance is necessary between nature and human environment. So human must learn to live and use environment in ramasthi. So human environment consists of human being themselves, an individual, a family, a community, a society that interacts in the form of social, political and religious groups and effect of each other life. So you can find such things in human environment. And here one story, small story is that Nuri was a girl from Mizoram, from the Ravi's class, and often talks about the last dream surrounding in of her place. Really, whenever you get a time, go and go to Mizoram, Leh Ladakh. So beautiful place, it's a paradise, you can say. So Ravi was upset to have her lost in his playground when he was coming. I told you here that like, as he saw this, all the playground is damaged, building is there. So Nuri invited him to visit the home and stay during the coming vacation. Ravi asked, the teacher asked the student to draw the landscape, houses, activity, places they visit during the holidays. So this is about the human environment. Then the major problem in the world are the result of difference between how the nature works and the way the people think. Actually, how the nature works, we use more and more misuse of resources. We never think about resources. A beautiful environment. I will appeal to you, my dear children. Please plant two trees or two plants, saplings, at your home. And please and please take care of this. Don't go for outside putting all these things. But only your home near. You can place in your balcony or here there is a garden. You can put in the, keep in your garden or any place near the kitchen you have or outdoor corridor of your home. But at least one plant you should plant it on your birthdays, on your mother's birthday, on your father's birthday. By that you can collect more and more variety of plants. Environment starts from your home only. So there are so beautiful plants. When you go through the many plants, snake plant is so beautiful, it gives you more oxygen. So there are so many different variety of plants. You go take purchase that plants and please plant one of the tree. It is my appeal to you. Start from your home. Charity begins from home. Small plant. When you started taking care of all these things, you definitely taking care of your environment. Start small things from your home. And really, I'm telling you, you will enjoy when you see it's going on growing or giving the flowers. So you will find very good, you know. So please and please plant your trees. So this is a major problem in the world. Things are different between the, how the nature works and the way the people think. Then we have an activity. I think so we had already done in our classroom this activity. Take the some of the elder person in your neighborhood and collect the information about the tree in your neighborhood or in what age. See, nowadays I am noticing that the bubble tree are becoming less, you know. You wherever you find bubble tree, check it whether it's bubble tree have a thorny, and you will find mostly in Rajasthan and the Gujarat part of the Gujarat because the dry plant you will find in this dry desert. So please go through. Sometimes you check your trees near. When you come to the school, you watch the trees, which trees are this hair or what tree. Start thinking in that way, what is this tree? Where it will grow? Where, what is this vegetation? Which breed it is or which species it is? You start thinking on this way. And here one activity, please copy this activity in the that I think so it is in your textbook, this activity. Go to the page number 5 and you will find this activity. How did you make this indoor games and all activities? Go through the page number 5 and do this activity. Right. And please, those who are not submitted the assignment, submit the assignment. And those who are doing revision, I am really appreciating you. You are doing very good revision. And really, we are feeling very good. See, when you send some mails to us, na, it means our bonding is there. Our attachment is there. That means you are missing me and I am missing you. That is why it is important to be continue about all this thing. Right, my dear children? Okay, thank you and God bless you.